There are a lot of moving legal parts in the efforts to provide financial compensation to the One October victims and survivors. There's the pending $800 million settlement between MGM and about 4,400 claimants. But tonight, we have some new information on what's happening with the $1 million estate of the gunman, Stephen Paddock.
Yesterday, a dismissal of the class action suit against Slidefire was achieved.
A major milestone, according to Alice Denton, the probate attorney responsible for dispersing the gunman's $1 million estate to the people who lost their lives at the Route 91 Harvest Festival. Slidefire, the company that made the bump stocks used by Stephen Paddock so his weapons could simulate fully automatic rifles, was the target of a class action lawsuit filed by Las Vegas attorney Robert Eglett. In the stipulated settlement, Slidefire also agreed to drop its creditor's claim on the Paddock estate. Denton says that should clear the way for the estate's value to go to the victims, except
there's a fugitive lawsuit that has been filed by two plaintiffs, improper person, which is still pending. And until that is dismissed or resolved, Slidefire doesn't believe it can withdraw its creditor's claim.
It also means Paddock's weapons are still evidence, and having them destroyed was a condition of an anonymous $65,000 donation to the victims. With the Slidefire case settled, Eglett hopes the guns can be destroyed soon.
No one wants those guns to exist anymore. No one wants, you know, a collector to think that's a cool momentum, because it's not.
But at this point, Denton says the $65,000 donation has been withdrawn.
After Slidefire filed their creditor's claim, the donor did take back his offer. The money was refunded to him because he did not want in any way Slidefire or any manufacturer of guns to get this money.
So here's where it stands tonight. If that separate lawsuit against Slidefire is dropped, Paddock's guns can be destroyed, and Denton thinks that she can also get the $65,000 donation back on the table. And it also means that proceeds from Paddock's estate could start going out to the victims' families around the beginning of the year, along with that $800 million settlement between MGM and those claimants.